Hi, I'm Rachel Donegan. I am the Howe Library's Emerging Technologies Librarian, and I am here to show you how to make something every week. This is Howe Makers. Hi, and welcome back to Howe Makers. Today, I am introducing you to the Sphero Bolt, which is this adorable little rolling robot. You can code it using an app called Sphero EDU, which is available for Android, Chromebook, iPad, iPhone, pretty much any device. Will let you code with this little robot. You can have it move around, you can have it have different displays on it. You can do quite a bit with this. And if you've played around with Scratch before or Make Code or any other block-based coding language, you will have no trouble getting up and running with Sphero. These are going to be available as a kit with our takeout procedures at the library. We're not including the iPad, but we are including the Sphero and the charging base. So this is how you charge your Sphero. It comes with this little sort of very futuristic looking little cup charger, and you just place the Sphero on top and you plug this end into your computer or any USB charging device. And it lasts for about 2 hours after it's fully charged, fully moving around for 2 hours. So you get a lot of play time out of this before you have to charge it again. So for this video, I'm going to use an iPad because that's what we use here at the library when we do a program with Sphero. So I'm just gonna turn this iPad on and you can see the app right there near the bottom, that one, Sphero EDU. Okay, so I've opened the app and I have my Sphero right here. It is not yet connected. I have to hit this button which says Connect Robot, and I have to choose the only robot there is to choose, and it's going to connect. And if you ever have trouble connecting, I mean, give it a couple of minutes to do its thing, but if you ever have trouble connecting to it, a good thing to try is to just connect the Sphero back to its base and plug it in for a minute. Sometimes that helps. Another thing you can do is make sure your device is close to the device that you're trying to connect it to, and just give it a couple taps to wake it up. Sometimes that works too. So you can see we are connected now. We have these bright pink LEDs shining in our Sphero Bolt, and you can see here that we're connected right here. It says SB2068, which is this Sphero right here. So we're all connected and ready to go. Okay, we're signed in to our Google account so I can save my programs, and I'm going to go down here to programs, and I have a bunch of programs in here already, but I'm going to go to this plus mark here to make a new one. And it's choosing block programming, which I'm going to do, and the Sphero Bolt. So I'm going to hit create. And I'm going to get a brand new programming window or project window. So a few things. It starts off with an onStart program block, which is good. That means when I hit this green button, it's going to run whatever code I write here. So I'm going to put a few blocks in. And here, down here has all the different kinds of blocks, so you can quickly get to them. You don't have to scroll through them all. So I'm going to start off with lights, main LED. And if you click on the color, you can change the color here. So maybe yellow. And then I'm going to have it do some rolling. So each of these circles you can also click on. So I'm going to roll 0 degrees. That just means directly away from me. And this is the speed. I'm going to go pretty quick. 4, 2 seconds. There we go. Then I'm going to have it stop. And then roll again. This time I'm going to have it roll back to me. So 180. Means it's going to roll back to me at the same speed, roughly, for 2 seconds. And then I will have it, actually, let's go back to lights. We'll change the light to something else. There we go. Then we know that the program has gone all the way through. So we're going to go try this out where we have a little more space. One more thing I want to mention too is this button right here says aim. This is important to aim the robot when you get started. And you push aim And you can see on the robot, it has this little, I don't know if you can see it, it's got this little blue tail light. Oh, see, I'll change it here. There we go. Now you can see, oops, let's go back there. You can see the blue tail light. So the blue, I kind of think of it as a tail light. So when you aim your robot and you aim the blue light towards yourself, 0 degrees heading will be that way. So opposite the tail light. So that is, so if I ran the program now, robot would run into the iPad for 2 seconds and then it would stop and then it would come back. So we're gonna actually try this somewhere where we have a little more space. Okay, well, that kind of worked. We can look at this and figure out why it didn't do exactly what I expected it to do. But after it runs through the program, it gives you this little graphical interface, which is kind of nice. So one of the challenges is to draw your initials with the Sphero. So this way you can see how well you did doing that. So I think for this program, what happened is it didn't stop for very long. And so it lost a lot of its energy doing the turn because it went the same speed roughly going out and coming back. So my hope was that it would come all the way back to its original starting point, and it didn't. So what I would probably do is go in and change the stop block to maybe a wait 1 second block so that it comes to a full stop before it comes back. And then we would probably get a different results there, and probably a better result or something we expect a little bit more. Because it does roll, there is a little bit of chaos built into the system. So another fun thing to do is play around with the LED matrix. That's something that the Bolt has that the previous version did not have. So I'm going to take all of these off here. I'm just going to put them over here for now. You saw when I touched this string, a red bar showed up on the bottom, and that's how you delete blocks. You can just pick up the blocks, and then there it is right there. You can just push them in there, and they delete. I'm going to hang on to that because I might need it later on, but it's not going to do anything because it doesn't have a black start block on it. So I'm going to grab this matrix animation one and put it up there, and if I click on the black grid itself, we can go in here and choose from animations. So I don't know what animal that is, but let's click on it. And then you have to go up here and click on the check to say okay. So now we have it there, and it's going to loop, which means it's going to do that until we tell it to do something else. So I'm going to go into controls and do a delay for 2 seconds, which is nice if you want to switch between things, is to give it a delay. Otherwise, things can happen so fast that you don't even notice them because the computer does it so fast. So I'm going to go back to lights, back over here to my matrix. So this time I'm going to make my own design. I'm going to click on the matrix again, and you can see one that I made before, but I'm going to make a new one, and you get this matrix here, and you can just draw whatever you want on here. All right, and anything I leave black is just not going to light up. So I kind of like that. I'm going to hit the check to okay it, and then I have it right there. So what's going to happen is when I hit this green button, it's going to do this first animation, and then it's going to stop for 2 seconds, and then it's going to do this design here. So mine was just a single static image, so it's not going to really be an animation, but let's see what happens. So that's how you get started with the Sphero Bolt. Hope you enjoy playing around with it. Check it out for 3 weeks, see what you can do, try some of the challenges, and share them with me. And I will see you next time. Bye.